And welcome back to the settlement of Alexandria. And we are right off into this battle. This is Ellington, and welcome back to Total War Rome 2. And we have got a 3v3 in-house battle today. This one actually was sent in to me a little while back, and I never got around to doing it. The day I remember that around the time that they sent me this battle, I had already done like 2 or 3 Alexandria battles in a really short period of time. And I was like, man, I cannot do another Alexandria battle right now. And thankfully, I saw it laying around in my replay folder and remembered to do it now, months later. So I apologize to Big Bees from, JJJ, who is Athens. Yeah, JJJ, who is Athens here. He is the one who sent it in to me, and I do apologize that I did not get around to it till now. Now, his allies, we've got Iceni being commanded by Kirky, and we've got Gete being commanded by J-Barbs. And for the defenders, we have got Colchis being commanded by Mr. Bubbles. We've got Egypt being commanded by Big Bees. And finally, we've got Bactria being commanded by Saturate. So this is going to be a fun one because these are all 6 really good players. And so I am really interested to see how this goes. Now, standard attack here on Alexandria. Typically, you are busting down the walls. Kind of varies who, person to person. But you're typically busting down these walls right to then push into this courtyard, as well as pushing down this way. Then typically what you see a little bit later, you will typically see a kind of late push to the left after progress has been made here. But once again, it varies a little bit person to person, game to game. So we do have Gete over here with some spears. Looks like he's getting on a tower. I'm not sure. Well, he was on a tower and then he got off the tower, so I'm not sure what he's doing now. They also have a tortoise over here that means that they can eventually come over and take down walls if they want to. Noble Blood Cavalry General from Colchis coming out, as well as, I believe that's a Ptolemaic Cav from Egypt here. Yep, so 2 pretty good Cav units. These Gete Spears unfortunately do not have javelins, so yeah. Typically, that is your best defense against the against cavalry, honestly, is javelins. You know, obviously having a good, bonus versus large helps and such, but, yeah. Now, defenders have pretty much given up this area. So, they have given up the courtyard, allowing units to push into here. They're also pretty much giving up this entire area as well. As of right now, we got some Rhodian slingers getting some shots off while they can. And then they've given up over here too. So, they have given up pretty much this entire section of the wall. So I would not be surprised if here soon we probably will see these tortoises moved forward to destroy that wall. Got some thorax swords here. Over on the left, the cavalry still just kind of, they're just kind of sitting there, right? They're kind of circling. They're making sure that the attackers know that they are there and are, aware that, hey, I'm right here. I'm right here. You better keep something looking. It splits the attackers' attentions into different places. So, a good call there. So, what's going to be really painful here? So, as the attackers approach into this area, what's going to happen is they're going to get shot a lot. There will be a lot of fire coming in from the archers from this side, And it's going to be pretty painful, I'm not going to lie. It's going to hurt. So now if they can get their own archers in to possibly zone them out, that might change. But I hate to say that might be a bit difficult. They just don't have as good of an archer position as these archers do. But here we go. The attackers moving in. Thorax Swords going first. They already have 82 kills. They're doing pretty well. Sword Band in behind. They're going to set up for some javies right into the backs of this Hillman unit. Watch this. Or I'm going to sit here and look like an idiot. Yep, I'm going to sit here looking like an idiot. So he didn't want to... I'm guessing he probably just didn't want to waste his javelin on Hillman, would be my guess. The thing is that at this point, I don't know that you have much of a choice other than doing so. Just given the fact that they're using their own javelins against you, if you don't counter that, in the end, you're going to hurt anyways. So that's my only thought there. Now over here we have Bactria's Persian Light Archers shooting into the Thorax. So what I'm a bit surprised, so what I think we're probably going to see, so Athens actually beat me to the punch here. I was going to say that Colchis would probably try and set up like this. The problem is he only brought regular Axemen. Had he brought the Cartley Axemen, he could have done exactly what Athens did, which was shield wall in a position that would lead Athens to look that direction, which would open up a really good shot for the archers here. But Athens actually ended up doing it instead. So what did that for him? He went to shield wall, which forces his formation to stay relatively looking the way he wants it to, which means that he doesn't have as good of an angle anymore as, or Bactria doesn't have as good of an angle anymore as he could have had. That is where, so typically the rule of thumb is that formation attack is pretty much just not good to have. There are rare situations that it can be good. This is one of those rare situations because formation attack doesn't allow your unit to circle around or get around other units, which then expose you to fire from the other side. You know, formation attack keeps your formation in a straight, right where you want it to be, in a straight, solid line so that your unit doesn't go a wonky and providing unnecessary angles to the enemy. But I would say at least 8 times out of 10, you want your formation attack off. Now, typically, mostly the units that are going to have formation attack are mostly going to be Hellenic units. There are obviously some outside of the Hellenic, you know, genre, whatever you want to call it, but that tends to be where you see the majority of them. Is in your Hellenic units. You also see it in like Messacily, you see it in Galatia, but in most of your barbarian factions, you don't typically have to worry about it. Now see, this unit is kind of in an odd spot. He's in shield wall, but it's all facing this way and really getting hit in the side there. Yeah, I think you just noticed that. Now he's moving. You can see some artillery coming in. I wonder if they've destroyed the Colosseum. I honestly think that could be really big if they have not destroyed this. They do have 2 artilleries, so we've got the Athenian artillery right back here, and we've got the Getae artillery right over here. Getae's artillery has already got some kills. He's got 23 kills. Now, what's interesting about his position is he is not going to be able to assist much through here, and probably not much through here. But it does give him a much, because of this positioning that he put himself in, it gives him a range that probably reaches back here. Let me see if it gives us, no, it's, well, maybe. Yeah, it does. So, looks like the attacking artillery goes to right there. And that's a lot, guys. Look at this. This is the victory point, right? So, the Getae artillery has great range. Will he be able to use it? That is what we will find out later in the battle, because we don't know. He may not get to a point where that range is that useful to him. And he may regret putting himself in a position where he can't assist in this frontal area just due to the angle that he's at, because there, you can see, look at that sharp decline there to where that ballista is. That means that his arcing shot can't really get probably much closer than, I would say, here-ish, you know, with the odd shot, but yeah. Iceni's got Chosen Sword Band going in. They should do relatively well against the Axemen here. Then we've got Mercenary Axe Warriors from Gete ready. Over here, we got a lot of Chosen Sword Band. Mercenary Axe Warriors already in combat. The two Cav units still sitting outside. So Athens brought his Epeus Lancer over here to kind of just keep an eye on things. The Ptolemaic Cav is better than the Hippias Lancer, but the Hippias Lancer can at least maybe kind of zone them out, make them think a second about coming over. Had a little bit of an archer duel going on there between Dacian Heavy Bows and I think Persian Light. So we do have two Syrians that I can see right off the bat, and I assume there's a third. And then, obviously, the Persian Light Archer to fill the fourth archer spot. Maybe we're going to get something over here. Got some units set up. Yeah, we might. Cretan Archers moving forward. They might be moving up to try and counter that archer position that we were talking about earlier with, you know, getting shots into the backs here. Unfortunately, they don't have the greatest position of fire onto this position. Probably their best bet is going to be setting up for jabby tosses. This spot here is a pretty good spot, mostly if you're holding something like this, because then you have a really good back shot into the attackers. But more Dacian Heavy Bows moving up. They're trying to double-team the Syrian. Syrian's down to 89 at 120. The other Syrian not engaged. Now he is. Oh, here you go. You got the odd shots coming from the Athenian Ballista. Interestingly, we've got the Eastern Archers of Colchis shooting kind of straight into the Chosen Sword Band. But now, yeah, he stopped. I was like, I don't know if that's the greatest position to fire here. The Athenian archers backed back up. So, did they even... Okay, so they got one of them got one kill. I don't know if that was just now. Artillery! Oh, right over their heads. Bactrian Royal Guard has actually taken a chunk of damage. He's taken 18 men lost. These Chosen Sword Band are kind of getting swarmed. You can see they're kind of going in. You got one or two coming in. But look how many units from Colchis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 flags within this area here. And you can see that nasty crossfire between the two artilleries. You know, even as they may not be getting a lot of kills right off the bat, what that really can do is just make the defenders think much more about their positioning, right? It means that they can't just sit there and line up a bunch of troops ready to move to the front, right? They have to scatter, they have to move their units around, keep them kind of spread out a little bit so that artillery can't find a good, consistent shot, right? The bigger the clump is, the more chance you're going to get hit. So that in and of itself, you know, changes the strategy of the defenders quite a bit. You know, I have never been a fan of not bringing artillery at all as an attacker, because it gives you no way to punish the defenders for their positioning. The better that you can do that, the more damage you can do. Bactria's got a ballista or a scorpion over here. Got 18 kills so far. They've also got a Rhodian up on the wall. I'm not particularly sure. Maybe it's just so that he can run it over here quickly if he needs to, because he's not really in a great position here. Understood. Quick march. Still nothing on this side. Once again, I don't think it's going to happen till a little bit later. Artillery coming in over here again. What's he got on him? 58 kills, and Gete 27 kills. I don't know why they've got this. This tortoise has been walked all the way from over here, and I'm not sure exactly what their plan is with it. They already have a tortoise. I guess maybe they want to bump two walls? I don't know. Chosen Sword Band and Thorax Sword having the most entertaining fight of all time. Shield wall v. shield wall. I do love the look of the Bactrian units. That, like, really nice blue. They're taking quite a few losses in this area. I don't believe the defenders have actually been doing a lot of those back shots that I was telling you about earlier. It really doesn't look like it. Yeah, I mean, these Cretans have barely any kills. This one has no kills. Egypt. I'm not sure what they're doing. You can see they opened quite the breach here. Look at this. This side here has been very, very painful. Good cycle there by the Axeman of Colchis. And he does have some Cartly Axeman, apparently. Just realized that. This one, 179 damage, or kills, excuse me. Nicely done. Oh, right through a Thoros spear. Ooh, piece of candy. Ooh, piece of candy. Looks like the attacker's gaining a little bit of ground here. Some good jabbies coming in. So the Thoros spears do have javelins, and they're throwing right over the heads into the backs. That's a noble sword. Gete getting in with the heavy hitters. Got two of them coming in. That's exactly who they're focusing down with those. Well, maybe not. I thought that was going to be they'd be focusing down with the javelins, but it is not. All right, so now we got double noble swords. Got one in here, one in here. And head-to-head, they will win this fight. But with the backup of the two Thoros spears, that could change if they have javelins left. We do have archer fire coming in from Bactria. They are getting some decent kills there. Surprised that we haven't seen a couple more units try to set up and get ready to help here. A lot of these units here are all depleted. 71, 90, 99, 49, 139. 47 now on Gete's artillery. Artillery! 113 now on the Athenian one. Very nice, very nice. All right, so we had a headhunt, battle rhythm. They're trying to move their thorax out of that fight there so that the thorax isn't the one taking the damage from the headhunt and the battle rhythm. They would rather the Thoros spear took it. It's a cheaper unit. The thorax is going to be better at killing than the Thoros spear will, especially if that Thoros is out of ammo. Noble Swords, 108 kills. This one not doing as well though. It's only 103 kill, or 33 kills. And here's the other Syrian that I couldn't see earlier. A couple more Thorax from Bactria moving in. They are just laying into this packed up mob here. This Thorax still hanging in there, 128 kills. Levy Thoros coming over. You know what he's here for. All he's here for is to javvy at these noble swords. Up on the wall, we've got a couple Briton slingers. A interesting call, given all the Bactrian archers here. I think Bactria is about to say why. Tell me why. Are you on that wall? Yeah. I don't know that that was a very good call there by Iceni. A little bit of breaking on both sides. Got one Axeman, and I think that was a Chosen Sword band.
We await your command.
Lot of reinforcements, though. On both sides, they are well supported. So, balance power, I would say, man, it'd be like 51% in favor of the defenders, 49% favor of the attackers. That's how close it is. But I do think that it's itsy-bitsy a little bit in their in the defender's favor. So far, no push over here. Do have one Chosen Sword band coming in here, but yeah, as of now, nothing on the left. Got a couple units over here, but nothing crazy. Honestly, most of the units are inside the walls at this point, so. Tasting heavy bows. Well, they're getting shot, but I don't think they're shooting back. It's not good for your health. Yeah, he's taking damage here. 54 kills on that Dacian heavy bow. Britain Slingers look like they may have gotten themselves out of trouble, and now they're just slinging down into this fight. 27 kills and 10 kills. I can't believe this Thorax is still alive. Iceni kind of getting through here. This poor, poor unit is just holding out for dear life. I'm amazed that it hasn't broke by this point. This honestly is not looking great. This area, they just have a lot of holes and seemed a little lackadaisical when it comes to their response to this position. They have, oh my god, Noble Sword, 253 kills. Good lord. I don't know what the other one got. I don't see it anymore, so it must have died. This side has not, personally, I don't think it's gone great for the attackers, but this side seems to have been going really well for it. Ballista, 62 kills and 128 kills. I'm just not sure that these slingers are really finding that much purchase on these shots. You know, they're kind of shooting straight into this combat and straight into the enemy shields. So I'm just not sure that it's really doing that much. 44 kills and 26. And it seems like they've used quite a bit of ammunition. Bactrian Royal Guard, the general of Bactria, has been getting shelled like almost the whole game. Over here, still nothing. A little bit of an archer engagement, though. Got Cretans going to be Cretans, but I'm a bit, little surprised that these Britain Slingers should be supporting this, and I'm not sure why they aren't. They could double team this Rhodian Slinger if they wanted to. Very interesting, wouldn't you say? Here comes another Noble Sword coming in. They have another Noble Sword back guarding the artillery. I just noticed that that was a Noble Sword back there. And here we go. Now we've got the walls being taken down over here. What that really causes for the defenders is it causes more elements of surprise, right? It basically allows the attackers another avenue into the settlement, which means that it's another place the defenders now have to watch and dedicate units to doing so. What that can mean is a compromise of this position, because if the attackers are able to gain any sort of foothold here, this position is no longer tenable at that point. That means you basically have to fall back And if you have to fall back from here, it basically means you have to fall back from here. And you have to fall back from here, you might as well fall back from here, causing everybody to get back here. You know, in most situations, not all. But I honestly don't think that's going to happen this game. Just because, honestly, the attackers don't have the units out here to dedicate to trying to push this position. So, in all reality, it's basically just going to hog up two units, maybe even one unit from the defenders to watch that position. It's really not going to pull that much off of the front lines, I don't think. But here, there's just another Noble Sword. It's 124 or 149 men with 26 kills. Oh man, they really want to get something in there to stop this. Okay, so the Noble Sword turned while the Chosen Sword Band went straight. But honestly, I think they should have done it the other way around. I think the Noble Sword should have stayed straight ahead while the Chosen Sword Band went the other way due to the Levy Throw Spear Javelins. So now the Noble Swords are getting shot in the back and the side by the Javelins when it should be... You want the Noble Swords not dying to Javelins. Rodian Slingers over here now. Are they shooting? Oh, I guess they are finding a shot over into this position over here. Chosen Sword Band is now gone. So now it's just the one, you know, they're trying to get this one through. But this one is down to 81 men. He is getting beat up. 62 kills. That hurts a lot. I think what we're going to get now, I think they're going to bring a Levy Thuros over here to guard while the Cretans come over here to shoot. The Egyptian cavalry is still sitting over here, Ptolemaic Cav. So they're bringing the Levy Thuros just to kind of protect the archers for a moment while the archers come. And I think they're going to try and shoot into this combat. They could be going for the Syrians, but I don't think they are. So they can no longer get onto this wall to deal with these archers or the slingers. So really the only way they're going to be able to deal with that is going to be with their own archers. But what they... Okay. So archer v. archer with slinger probably going to sling over here. Nope, they are all going the archers. They are putting it all into that. They also took a pot shot at the Noble Blood Cav Gen. Cartley, 78 kills. Bounce power is still just about the exact same as where it was. 112 kills on the ballista. And where did the crew go? What the hell? Oh, there they are. 229. So the Athenian ballista doing extremely well. The Getae Ballista still not quite, you know, leaning into it. Hear that cab moving around. Ptolemaic Cav returning, it looks like. Pais Lancers come over here once again, I think, just to help zone out. Britain Slinger's now getting shot by the Syrians, and here comes the Ptolemaic. He's moving up. I don't think he dares go into the... Oh, this is a Thorax Hoplite, so he might. You know, the Hoplite can't punish him with the Javies, so he might be willing to try and get into this. 44, 55, charge bonus 57, 63... Ptolemaic, he's getting out of there mostly due to the archer fire. Because of that, he doesn't want to get into the fight. If it wasn't for the archers, I guarantee he would have taken that fight. To be honest with you, Egypt, I don't think you're probably going to find anything here.
Fire on the enemy!
And every time we go back and look at this position, it looks more and more dire. Troops breaking left and right. Other troops rushing in to try and fill the gaps. Oh, here's the Noble Blood Cav. So now they're going to have both generals outside again. But right as I say that, the Hippias Lancer now, or the Ptolemaic now, looks like he wants to leave. All right, here's the pullback. That was it. That was the final straw there. And, yep, just like I said earlier, I think we're going to see everything falling back now. Now, this is where Getae's artillery can be of a really big impact, right? All these units are going to be more focused on leaving and less focused on being careful about bunching up. So, well, maybe they're going to stay. Nah, I think you throw this Egyptian infantry, plug the gap, get everything back if you want, if you can. I think you either do it or you don't do it, right? I'm not a huge fan of kind of, well, maybe kind of, sort of. Because the question here is, it's not whether you think or can you hold this. The question is, do you think you can hold this, right? This is your best option of getting out. I mean, you do have the option of going this way, but once the attackers are through this, this is threatened too. So, I don't know. I'm not a fan of half measures. I think you either do it or you don't do it. If you're going to fall back, then fall back. If you're not going to fall back, then you stay. Ooh. Ow, Javitas. Interesting. I don't think he actually lost anything in that javelin throw, so. Huh. Interesting. Ooh, Scorpion now getting shot up by the Levy Theros. He was trying to set up to start shooting right down this. Honestly, it's a good shot. You know what I mean? You have clear shot all the way down here. So you have a clear shot the entire way down. And I bet even as he pulls back, he still has a good shot. So now we got Galatian. The Dacian heavy bowmen coming up. Looks like they're gonna, well, actually got what, two Dacian heavy bows, an archer, and two slingers are gonna come over here and take on the two Cretans that you've got here. They have a third Cretan, which they may try to get involved. I'm curious as to how much they're actually going to commit to attacking this. I think they're holding right outside the tower range. That's good. Thorax holding the front line. Got a Cartly Axeman ready to go in from behind. Honestly, the Cartly might even just go in now. Going up against a healthy Thorax sword here. Your more depleted one could probably use a bit of help. A little surprised at all of these. They've got a lot of lower tier units still around that you don't typically see this late into a battle. You know, we were looking at three Egyptian infantry sitting back here. Usually those low tier infantry are typically some of the first units you're seeing in the actual combat. So I'm interested that they still have this much left of them. Eastern Archer back here. Looks like they're out of ammo. 110 kills on them. Got a Slinger here. Actually getting shot. Look at that. They're actually getting shots over here. Cheeky, cheeky. Now, what could be really interesting is I wonder if maybe we see a counter push here, which then threatens the back end of the attack. That could take a lot of pressure off of this point and probably this point, honestly, because I don't think they're going to go this way anytime soon. Well, maybe not. Look at all this. Got a lot of stuff coming over from Getae and Iceni, so maybe they will. Shots off on the Noble Blood General. Take aim. So what they're going to need here, they're going to need, you know, multiple units to come in here, engage all three sides, and also units to be set up behind to move in and support. Looks like they're also bringing pretty much their entire archer force over here to gain the superiority. They want to get rid of this, and they want to get rid of whatever's over here. I think they're Easterns. Mercenary Syrians on the wall seem to be out of ammo. Not much of a counterattack, but they did push forward. I think, honestly, probably just to gain a little bit of ground for the archers to move forward to then shoot further away, possibly. Not much for the attackers set up to go to this position. Axemen up on the wall. Very depleted noble sword general. 48 kills, man. He got focused down. There we go. Here comes the archer. Oh my god. You see the Eastern archers just disintegrate. It's a downside to Eastern archers. They just don't have any armor. 10 armor. So they get sneezed on and they die. Same thing these Persian lights, but they're out of ammo. And so are the Syrians. So, yeah, there's no archer presence over here other than what was over here. Cretans now get some shots in over here. And still a fight going on way back here. You don't usually see this big of a fight going on, like, way behind where the main battle lines are, which are way up there. But it's interesting to see. Oh, the Levy Thorough Spears. Oof. Cretans 192. They still have ammo. And 101, and they still have ammo. Getting a bit thin over here. Bounce power still seems to be in the defender's favor, but don't know how long that'll last. Heroic nobles from Iceni somehow made their way all the way over here, but now they're just getting charged by Ptolemaic Cav. Ptolemaic is getting shot every time it comes forward. Cretans of Athens still have ammo. They still have ammunition. Quick march! Yeah, this is pretty much gone. A lot of what the defenders have left seem to be dedicated over here. I'm not sure what they actually have left to defend this site. We're about to find out pretty quick, because here soon we'll see what they have back there. Now, most of what's up here, got, well, two decently healthy thorax swords, a decently healthy Egyptian infantry, but that's it. So you got one healthy thorax, a half-strength thorax, healthy Egyptian infantry. Uh-oh. Got a breakthrough by the defenders.
Cut them down.
Getting in on the archers. Thorax is going to come over, but he's pretty weak. Ambushers have come over. This could be bad. If the defenders can beat this stuff over here, that's going to allow them to fully dedicate back towards the point. Egypt's infantry still kind of chilling. But here come the Getae noble swords. Still healthy, 130 men left. I'm a little surprised as to why this unit isn't engaging. Especially when that Thorax sword is pretty weak, so the noble sword's going to make pretty short work of it. Here we go, some Rhodian slinger action. Getting in on the Cretans. Ptolemaic Cav is going to threaten, but he's taking heavy shots while he does so. Not sure that was worth.
Fire on the enemy!
The Paeus Lancer General might be able to deal with this now. Yes, Hebe's Lancer is still healthy, so if he wanted to, he could probably come threaten this Ptolemaic and make him go away. Got to be careful of the Noble Blood Cav in support, though.
Yes, Commander.
All right, so there's still a couple units left over here. Sword Band. What was I seeing? Thorospears. The broken unit, that's why. Look at this. Mercenaries here in Archer got off the wall and came over and recapped the tower here. The depleted Hero Noble is going to go try and stop him. We'll see if he makes it. He might die to the Hero Tower. Better just retake the tower there, Iceni. I think it's your best bet.
Advance at speed.
Man, there's a lot of big spaces here for the defenders to fill, and they really don't have very many troops to do it with. I wonder if Athens might try to take his general the back way. So you can actually go like this. See, there's a path right here that you can take and come over here. Now, obviously, the defenders would see it, but it might force them to dedicate more troops to more position.
Hold position. As you command.
This is going to be an interesting end to this because in some ways the defenders have really pulled back an advantage, but some ways they were pretty scattered too, so I'm interested to see what's going to happen here in the next couple minutes. Getae's general is dead. The Athenian general is alive. Iceni's general is dead. Positive he's dead, right? He's got to be dead. Only has 12 men, and there's no way he's alive. I don't see the general's dead penalty. I'm trying to see if it'll change. Like, seriously? As far as I can see, the Iceni general is still alive somehow. I would love to know if any of the attackers are still or are watching this replay, or if Iceni specifically would probably know. Is your general alive with 12 men? Because that's lucky, man.
Get
Lucky, lucky. He's trying to sneak through, but I don't think he's really got a spot there. I guess. I think he's realizing he doesn't have a spot. Or he just didn't want to get charged by the Egyptian infantry. And he's probably coming over here to deal with the noble blood calf. This unit's kind of strung out, though. That wasn't the greatest charge. He needed a good charge. Especially given that he's a heavy shock, or very heavy shock cav. He really needed to get that charge, because that's where he's going to do all of his damage. Scorpion, 90 kills. And here's the Iceni units back here. Well, regardless of whether the Iceni general is dead or not, he did break.
Break the lines. Square formation. Advance at speed.
Noble Sword's going to get a lot of kills here, but in the end, I think they're going to get overwhelmed.
At speed.
Yeah, look at that. 24 men left.
Orders under squires at the double.
I'm just trying to figure out where is the balance of power coming from for the defenders here. I mean, it's got to be ammunition, right? Maybe ammo from the Scorpion might be doing it. They do still have some healthy infantry, but... man, I don't know. I just didn't expect it to be this slanted. Like, the balance of power. The Paeus Lancer, if he can get in there, and I don't know why he doesn't try to get in there now. You've got an opening over here. He doesn't want to go this way because he's getting shot. So he might, well, now he might. I was going to say he might go through now. Yeah, I think he's going to go now. Thorough Spear's going in now. I think for the attackers to win at this point, they really need to make good use of this cav. This cav needs to get in there and do some damage. If this cav can get in there and do some real good damage, I think it turns this around. I don't know why you turn off that. I think you go into this. Yeah, I'm not sure why he pulled off of that spot. He definitely had the opening to get in the archers, and he could have gotten here or here. Yeah, I'm a bit surprised by that move. This is an archer unit over here, so he can go through. He literally just took the long way around. What? Yeah, I don't know why he just did that. He just took the long way around. This cav's got to get moving. You got to be moving. Hit him and hit him hard. I seen these units broke. I think they're going to pull it back. I think this is attacker's game. I think the existence of the cav here at the end is going to pull this back. Yeah, that's GG. I honestly don't think that the bounce power should have been that slanted, but the cav had to get the worth. If the cav didn't get in here, it was the attackers probably could have won this, but or the defenders probably could have won this, but with the cav getting in, that was GG. The defenders just at this point, they have no answer to the cavalry. So that's going to be it. Just finishing off a couple units here, one axeman, one archer. And that's it, GG. Well fought. All right, let's look at some kills here. First off, we've got JJJ as Athens with 1,922 kills. I'm a little disappointed in the archers here. A little bit low on those. 207 on the calves, really good. Pulling it back there at the end. A couple of his throw spears specifically did pretty good. Kirky as Iceni, 2,344 kills. His two heroic nobles did pretty good. Slingers did pretty good. Infantry, just pretty solid. J-Barbs as Gete with 1,927 kills. Let's see, Dacian Heavy Bows, three of them did pretty solid. The artillery did pretty good. The noble swords, man, a couple of them had a rough day. Just, man, they got focused down. Also, are they using the Pila rule, maybe? Looks like they might be using the Pila rule, where it's like four range, one Pila. Or four, like, archers, one Pila. For the defenders, we have Big B's as Egypt, 2,064 kills. Let's see, archers and slingers all doing excellent, two chevrons on each of these. The Ptolemaic Cav having a rough day. Infantry, just solid. We've got, who's Mr. Bubbles as Colchis with 2,004 kills. Two archers doing really well, a slinger 259. Let's see, a lot of his Cartleys did pretty solid. 192 on a Cartley Axeman there, 238, 199. Then finally, for the defenders, we've got Saturatus Bactria, 1,836 kills. Archers did really well there. His infantry, they did solid. They did okay. A couple of them not doing so hot, but for the most part, pretty good. Really, honestly, top to bottom, look at how similar the kills are. That shows you that you are in a match, or that you're watching a match with very evenly distributed skill here. Between all of these players, they're all in relatively similar skill levels, and that's where you get your best games. So, a really good replay. Thank you so much for sending this one in. Don't forget that if you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, and we will see you guys next time.